In the next month, Airtable is making sweeping changes to the way that it deals with the attachment field inside of any Airtable database. If you are using the attachment field, you must know what these changes are because they could impact your workflows. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. My name is Gareth and I own Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you automate the bullshit. We do that with no-code tools so that anyone can start deploying custom-built solutions that don't require any code to whatever your specific workflow is. If you want to learn the fundamental building blocks of automation, check out my free webinar. You can sign up for that at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration, and I will include links below. But without further ado, let's hop into the heart of this video. We have got to talk about these upcoming changes. These changes are going to be going live in early November 2022. So if you're using the attachment field, make sure that you've given some attention to this matter. So let's go ahead and hop into Airtable support article that they've written to kind of get a backstory about what's going on here. I'll be sharing a link to this support doc as well so that you can also go and get an up-to-date view of what's going on inside of this new upcoming change. So hopping on into this, we've got the changes coming to Airtable attachments. The attachment field type is a field type in Airtable that allows us to put basically a file in there, a PNG, a JPEG, you can even drop in a video file, an Excel file, a CSV. Any kind of file that you can imagine pretty much can be stored inside of that attachment field type. But the way that it works is going to be changing. Some big changes are coming. So that's the field type that we're talking about. These changes are coming on November 2022, and Airtable is saying, hey, this is a security measure that we're implementing. The security measure is going to be relating to all of these links that are created when a new attachment is added to an Airtable base. So what's happened historically, again, this is prior to the update, when you drop an attachment into the attachment field and you upload a new doc or any sort of file into your Airtable attachment field, a public URL for that file is automatically created. And prior to the crossover on November 8th, 2022, anybody who has that public URL can access that document. And this is a security risk. And this is why Airtable is making these changes. Now, the big concern is that even if you were to delete a doc or delete a file from your Airtable base, but somebody for whatever reason still has that link, that URL, the public URL that's created when the attachment is uploaded, they can still access that public URL, at least they can prior to the cutover. So again, as I said already, and as Airtable has explicitly said right here, this is a preventative security measure that's being taken because obviously that solution isn't entirely secure. And while it's practically impossible for somebody to guess what that URL might be, it's also impossible for you to take access away. If you've already shared that URL with somebody after having uploaded an attachment in Airtable, you have no way to pull that back. And so now we are getting some more control over this, thank goodness. So what is not impacted by this? The following change does not affect the following. A form URL. If you have a form that is built in Airtable, it's not going to be messed with in these upcoming changes. The URL field. The URL field itself in Airtable, not going to be impacted. Google Drive, a box, or any third-party app storage devices or services. All of these third-party storage services, not going to be impacted by this whatsoever. And then also URLs in text-based fields, also not going to be impacted. What is impacted is the URL that's created by the attachment that is updated. So let's talk about what exactly that is. So here Airtable is spelling out what is exactly happening inside of these changes. Currently, Airtable attachments include a static URL where the attachment can be publicly accessed via a web browser. So any attachment that's added into the attachment field type, as I mentioned earlier, automatically gets this public URL created and it can be shared with anyone. Now this link never expires, and this is a big catch right here. The current way that it's set up is that that link comes into existence, never goes away. It can be accessed literally by anyone who can guess that URL or who otherwise obtains the attachment's link. So this, as they say, presents potential security risk for files. So what are they doing? They're introducing They're expiring public accessible attachment links. So now when we go and upload an attachment to Airtable, any kind of file, it still gets that URL created for it, but it will expire. It's no longer going to be publicly available past a certain deadline, which is a huge plus. But this could potentially have massive impacts to the way you're using the attachment file. So stay tuned towards the end, and I'm going to show you a workaround that I'm going to have to reimagine for myself, because this is going to impact the way that I post to social media. But before we get to that, let's talk more about what's happening here. Any attachment URL obtained via the public API and the CSV export functionality now expires within a few hours as of this update. Remember, this is coming November 8th, 2022. Also, URLs obtained from copying an attachment cell value. So if you're just doing a copy paste and you're opening that file to the attachment viewer within the product instead of directly opening the file. Now lastly, the links obtained by referring to an attachment field in formulas will not change for backward compatibility. So if you have a previous formula that's looking at an attachment field and you're trying to scrape out the URL inside that attachment field, the formula is still going to work, okay? But the will become invalid. So again, these links are only going to be valid for a few hours, as Airtable says, just a few hours after having been created. So while your formula can still decipher what that public URL is for backwards compatibility purposes, the URL is not going to work after a few hours. The file name obtained in the same way will continue to work as expected. So what is this going to impact? Well, Airtable customers should only experience benefits of the enhanced security related to the change. So Airtable is saying you're only going to get benefit from this. However, certain customer workflows in Airtable may be impacted. Are you one of them? Let's take a look. Number one, if you're using Airtable to host files on the internet, they added a little blurb here that says, "We have and will continue to discourage the use of Airtable for this purpose." This was unknown to me. Previously, I've been using Airtable to store my images for social media posts. I upload a ton of images to Airtable, thanks to all the videos and thumbnails and things like that that I produce for our company. And so if you're storing those files predominantly in Airtable, and you're not utilizing them immediately after having uploaded them, remember, we only get a 3-hour expiration window, then you could be in trouble here. So this is what's going to impact me, and I will walk through exactly what that particular workflow is so that you can see if it impacts you as well. Now, the other one is, any workflows where a file held within Airtable will need to be shared for a prolonged amount of time. Remember, you're only getting access to that for 3 hours or so. Airtable formulas, formulas that reference attachments fields will not experience changes in output, as we already said, but the attachment links to the output are going to become invalid. Also, CSV exports. You'll need to download any attachment files from the links in the exported CSV before the link expires. And also API. Similar to CSV downloads, any attachment links obtained via Airtable's API will also expire within a given amount of time. Okay. Recommended practices, this is where it starts to get good. When you're sharing a file with colleagues who have access to your base, Airtable is basically saying, look, if they have access to the base, then just share a link that includes access to the base. The issue comes if we're sharing access to a file that lives in a base that somebody does not have access to. If we just want to share a file from within our base and not share access to the base, then obviously this doesn't work. So now that we know generally what kind of impacts this new URL attachment is going to have, well, let's take a look at two live examples to see which of them will be affected and which will not. I'm going to start off with one where it includes an attachment that's going to be shared publicly with people outside of Airtable, but I am not going to be in violation of this new upcoming change. So let's start with that. Now, I've demonstrated this in a previous video, but what this workflow does is we have a form here that asks people to fill it out when they are ready to receive their certification. They give us their name and they give us their email. Now, when they are done with that, we will have collected the name and email address. We can also determine when this record was created, and we can also then create a document thanks to Document. If you don't know how to do this with automation, I would recommend checking out the links below where you can see this exact workflow. But we're going to create this PDF then when somebody submits this. Then what happens, check out our automations here, we're going to send the certificate. And we're sending that certificate. Basically, we're saying when the new certificate is created and added to Airtable, then we want to send it out through Gmail. So yes, we are sharing this particular attachment within a few moments of having it uploaded to our base. And we are sharing that publicly. We are sending it out via email. So will this or will this not be affected by the new changes? It will not be affected because of the fact that we are sending out this URL within just a few moments of having uploaded this attachment to our base. So remember, this particular URL expires in a few hours, as Airtable has said. In this case, this automation will have happened within just a few moments of the new piece being uploaded, so we don't have to worry about any implication to this workflow. Now let's look at a workflow that will be impacted. Here I have my video content database, where I track all of the content that we produce. And each piece of content that we produce, I'm uploading different files as well. You can see the thumbnails that we use on YouTube for these different videos. So for example, when I created this particular video about certificate automation, this was done a month ago in early September. And when I did that, of course, at that point in time, I then uploaded the video files as well. So I have here the YouTube image and the blog image. Bear in mind, these were uploaded over a month ago so that I could keep track and stay organized with all of my different images inside of Airtable. Well, here's where I have a workflow that will be impacted by this pending change. So over here in my next table, I have a table called posts. And this is where I plan out my social media posts. Now, every day I link to a particular piece of content. I write a quick social comment here that says, this is what I'm gonna say on this particular video. And I share that with my audience on LinkedIn, on Twitter, etc. Now this is all done through an automation in Zapier that waits for the scheduled date and time. And as soon as it becomes the current date and time, then that automation sends out a lot of stuff. It sends out a link to where they can find this particular video. That's gonna be the content URL. I'm looking this up from the content page, but I'm also looking up the image formula. And this is what I was talking about earlier, where you have formulas that will not be impacted by this change, but that this formula output will no longer be useful. So right now, if I click on this image formula, it's gonna access that public URL where this particular image is available. And I can use this right now in my automation, but remember, this URL is going to expire after a few hours of having been uploaded. So in the future, I won't be able to go back and look at old pieces of content that were created months ago as I've done here. This particular video, for example, was produced over 2 weeks ago. And so I can't use this particular video thumbnail in my automation in the future. Because again, I'm only gonna have public access to that URL for a few hours after it's uploaded. So what can you do? Upload that image to Google Drive or Box and build a more complex automation that will then take that image and upload it and share it where you need to go. I hope this cleared up any questions that you have about this upcoming change. I know there's a lot going on at Airtable behind the scenes, and by and large, this is going to be a massive positive movement because we're all getting more security from that attachment field URL. But yes, it is going to interrupt some workflows, so make sure that you go ahead and address any of those upcoming issues that you might have before the switchover on November 8th, 2022. If you want to stay on top of no-code news like this, be sure you've subscribed to this channel, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.